Shalom. Today we was in the 8th day of Chanukah. So we should mention what is special about this day. My rabbi make a parallel between the 8th day of Chanukah, the 8th candle, to 8 language of beauty that are in Hebrew. There are 8 different words to say beautiful in Hebrew. And in Kabbalah they correspond to the 8 spherot from Bina, from the mother, to the kingdom, to the Malchut. This is the mother, Bina. This is the father, Chochmah. After you have, and it is a crown, of course. After you have the Vav of the name of, this is the Yud-Kei of the name of God. After you have the Vav of the name of God, what is Chesed, Gvura, Tiferet, Netzach, Od, Yesod, Malchut. This is the name of the Sfirot in Kabbalah. This is the brand, the head, subconscious, up of the consciousness, the crown, and this is the heart, 6 attributes of the heart.
Heart.
And the kingdom, the last stage, usually is the speech that came after. Okay, so why there are 8 language of beauty, and why they start from the concept of Bina? Because what it is beauty? Beauty is always a reflection of light in a vessel. This is a concept of beauty. Right, so concept of beauty exists only from the place that exists concept of vessel. Chokhmah, wisdom, it's like just light. It's act of being vessel. The mother's understanding, it's here starts the concept of vessel. So the name of beauty that they are is Shefer, the first one, that is related to the first day of Chanukah. A Shefer is from the word Shofar, the Shofar that we blew in Rosh Hashanah. Shofar always has to do with the mother in Kabbalah, equal 10 times Chen. We say always that the concept of Chen has to do with the mother. After we have the word Yofi, what is rational word for beauty. Something is beautiful, so the more normal way to say beautiful is the word Yofi. Correspond to Avraham, the wife of Avraham. The Torah said about her that she was Yafa, she was beautiful. The Torah used about the wife of Sarah the verb beautiful. Another word for beautiful is Tov, that it means good too. But many times about women, the Torah says that they are Tovat Mar'e, good looking. Alright, so this was said about the Rivka, about the woman of Yitzhak. This corresponds to Avraham, always this corresponds to Yitzhak. Alright? Here we have the Tiferet, we have a beauty that called Pe'er. Pe'er, the same root of Tiferet, it means that there are a mix of many colors together. It's a beauty of many colors. You know, it's not one color, it's not one thing. When you mix things together, because here we have Yaakov and Esav, or Yaakov that really make connection between Avraham and Yitzchak, it's like the middle, so it's a beauty of all the colors together. It's like the vav that connect all the what around the vav, it's like the body that connects the hand and the legs. Okay? Here in Netzach we have a beauty that's called Noi. Noi, it's a word you use many times for decoration. beauty of decoration. It's the same letter of Yavan. All the culture of Yavan is a culture of beauty. Alright, so here we have a beauty that has to do with the same letter of Yavan, what it means.
Greece.
Greece, the culture of Greece, we have to take the Greek culture that become the Rome culture after this, and we have to put it in the tent of Shem, like the Torah said, Yeft Elohim leYefet veYishkon beOle Shem. Yefet, the father of the Greece, is Yefet, one of the son of Noah. Yefet is from the word Yofi. Alright, so all the concept of Greece have to do with beauty, the beauty of the nature, the beauty of art, etc. So there are a lot of One of the things of Chanukah is to take the beauty of Greece and to put it, to convert it.
Greece or Grace?
Greece, Yavan. Yeah, okay. Greece, to take the beauty and other things that are very good there, in philosophy, in it's a culture of the nature, of course. It's not above the nature. Alright, so in the nature, we can many times drown. Tavati, it means I drown, but it's from the word teva, what is nature. Tavati biven metzula, I drown in yeven metzula. Yeven, it's like metzula, it's like deep water. Yeven, it's like dust with the water, or
swamp.
Something deep, but it's the same word of yavan, what it means. Greece, Yavan, Greece. The same letter of Noi, etc. Alright, so we can drown in the beautiful of the nature. So we have to be careful, do not drown. Alright. Here we have Hod. Hod is a name for beauty. Hod. Hod is like a majesty, beauty of majesty. It's kind of beauty that the Torah said to Aaron. Here is the place of Aaron. The priests have this quality of this beauty. Here in Yesod we have a beauty that called Hadar. Choshoro Hadarlo, like it's a kind of beauty that has to do with Zebul, that has to do with Yosef, that has to do with the eighth king of Edom, that is the root of the soul of Yosef and Jesus, like we explained in different lessons. And in Malchut, what was the day with the beauty that called Chen. Alright? So, today it was a day of Chen, what is the word, what is our thing, what everything we teach is based on the word Chen, the Ark of Noah. Alright, start with Chen and finish with Chen. Alright, so this was shortly, and this is the Shamash, the secret of intermediate between the light. All the light are in the crown. In the crown there are 13 principles of mercy, and they are parallel to 13 different words for light that are in Hebrew. Alright, I am not going to write them now, but there are 13 different words to say light. Here it's like kavod, it's like Ananeka God, it's something between light and vessel. This is a Shama, the candle that with this candle we light the other candle. We say in all the blessings of Chanukah, where there are two blessings, each one of them have 13 words that related parallel to this 13 name of light. Alright, so all the idea of lighting the candle of Chanukah is to take the light from the crown, from the subconscious, and to put it through the shamash, through the intermediate, to all the vessel. And when the light shines through the vessel become beautiful. This is the concept of beauty. Alright, so This was shortly about this day, because we have to live in the time. Now, what really happened in Chanukah, so after they finished the war, they go to clean the temple to prepare it to renew the work in the temple. So we call it this preparation called Chanukah, Chanukat HaMizbeach. It's the idea of 8 days. Always a preparation. It's 8 days, like it is written Uvayom Hashmini, like Aaron, he was completely, they put it in the side for 8 days, have to be prepared, insulated from everything, and only after, in the 8th day, the temple or the Mizbeach is ready to start to work on it. It means all the concept of Beit HaMikdash have to do with the 8th day. Alright, it's something that is like behind this world.
Seven is like limitation of
this world. 8 always is something that came from Bina, from the mother. It's something that is above this reality.
So this reality is like the six dimensions, and then seven?
Yeah, exactly. So
7 is Shabbat, is transition to the 8?
In the Shabbat, it is revelation of the 8 too. Alright? You can say that the Sunday is a revelation of the 8 too. But usually we will say that in Shabbat, it is a revelation of the 8th day. Alright? So, to build the temple, it means to reveal in this world something that belongs to the 8,000, something that never happened yet. Alright? This creation is limited to 7 days, 6 days and another day. And when we build the Beit HaMikdash and do all the work that have to do with Beit HaMikdash is to reveal a light that really will exist only in the 8,000 year of creation. It's mean we reveal something that is not yet, we bring it from this place to this world. Right? This is all the idea of the 8 day. It's the same idea with the Brit Milah too. There are a few things that have to do with the number 8. Alright, so now we'd like to talk a little bit, if we get to the Beit HaMikdash, to the temple, I would like to talk a little bit about the place of the temple. Where Avraham took Yitzhak to be sacrificed, this is the place of the temple, like
the altar.
The altar, the place of the altar, that all the temple is decided by the place of the altar. What is in very close, where is the Even Ashtia, the special stone. Probably the place where it is the Arab Misgad.
The mosque.
It's not the place of Kodesh Kodashim, like there are people that think that the stone that is there is the stone of the place of Kodesh. It's not.
With the sacrifice.
Probably it's not the place, because there are many problems with saying that this is the place, with all kind of calculation. So really, today, nobody really know exactly what is the place, so there are different research about this. But probably the place that most of the people think that this is the place of Kodesh Kodashim is not. This, by the way. So what the Torah said about this place? Avraham, after his experience, God called him Avraham, special revelation. And then Avraham called this place Hashem Yireh, God will see. That will be said in this day, that God will be seen. Vayikra Shem Hamakom Hazeh, it is this place, he called this place Hamakom Hazeh. He called the name of this place Hashem Yireh, God will see, Yireh, God will see. That will be said in this day, in the future, God will be seen. God will see, God will be seen.
By us, by the humans.
God, yes. So it is a concept of God will see. It means something that have to do with high spirit. And God will be seen, something to do with low spirit.
The revelation for us.
It means we talk about two revelations. Revelation that is below, and revelation that is up.
Above.
Hamakom Hazeh, he calling him Et Yitzchak. Hashem Yireh equal my name. I'm sorry that I must to use my name, but this is the name of the temple, Ariel. This is the name of the altar. The altar, the name of the altar is Ariel. He was high. Chen Tfachim, 58 Tfachim.
Tefach is what?
Is
the unit measurement?
Yeah,
unit.
It's a measure. And so this equal to Ariel is the same letter two times. Hashem Yireh, Hashem Yireh. All right, so Ariel, Ariel equal Talmid, disciple. Yitzchak equal the Rav, disciple and Rabbi. Together equal Esav plus Yeshu. The two concepts, we talk about them all the time, that together form the name of Yeshua. Alright, so this is something very basic when we talk about the place of the temple. We see that it's one thing with the concept of Mashiach. When they used to do the sacrifice, it was came a flame in the form of lion. When God liked the sacrifice, he was a pure fire. This is the same letter of lion, Ariyeh. Ariyeh Avaya. It's like lion of God. And this is Ariel. It's like another name for lion, another name for God. But have the same gematria. Ariyeh. Avaya, Ariel of God, Yud Kevavke, and here is Ari, El. Ari is another name
The Lion of God?
Both have to do with what you call the Lion of God. Have the same gematria, because Yirah, Yireh, fear too,
will see.
It's the same, will be seen, will see, will be seen. It's the same letter of Ariel, what is a lion. Right, so all the temple, I would suggest that he had a form of a lion, and it was when they used to put the fire, when the priest used to light the fire, even he was came a fire from up, it was a mitzvah. We have to put a fire from below too. Right, it's like everything, even thing appear from heaven, we have to do it from earth too. So the priest light the fire here, and still came another fire from heaven with the form of lion when the sacrifice was accepted in goodwill. If not, it was a lion of a dog. If not, it was the form of a dog that ate the sacrifice when it was not receiving goodwill.